There have been too many discrepancies between exit polls and voting results, some of which have been more than 10% off from one another. Now, these exit polls are actually very reliable, and they're used to determine the validity of elections. For more on this, let's go to Lee Camp, the host of Redacted Tonight on RT America. Lee's been covering the issue of election integrity and has uncovered some pretty shocking information. So, Lee, you have done a fascinating job, a remarkable job, more so probably than anybody, at least in corporate media, anybody in independent media that I've seen, of covering this issue of election fraud, something that the Democrats, when it's not happening to them, think that it is a huge issue that needs to be addressed.
Right.
But these days, you know, it's just primaries, so we just kind of let this slide, right? I mean, that seems to be what's happening with the Democratic primaries.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that they're letting, especially the voter suppression slide, because that's going to hurt them definitely in the general, it's insane. And it's going on in a lot of different states, and the exit polls show this, the unadjusted exit polls. A lot of people don't understand that basically after 2004, when the exit polls showed blatant fraud in Ohio, the media then started asking the exit poll companies, hey, adjust your exit polls to make them fit with the machine numbers so that people don't see fraud, because it looks bad. It looks bad if the democracy is stolen. So just adjust those. So they do adjust them, but they have to wait until the machine vote is out. So throughout the day, you see the actual exit polls, and those actual exit polls in most states are way off, and they always seem to be off in favor of Bernie Sanders, meaning his exit polls do better than his machine vote. And the odds of that happening in these 23 states where it's happened and there's been primaries and not caucuses is like one in a trillion or something. It's absolutely not just by chance.
And it's remarkable. You covered this on Redacted Tonight, this meeting that they had in Chicago. Or Illinois, where they're talking about, you know, these people are coming forward who did the audits and say, look, we watched the machines be changed. We watched these results, you know, oh, well, Bernie won by 46 votes or however many. But then at the end, the whole tally went towards Clinton, and the election officials' there reaction was just a big, huh.
Right.
Okay.
A big shrug. Yeah. And in most states, I think there is an audit or a mandatory audit or something of a certain percentage. And in Chicago, it's 5%. And you can go and witness these things. And so these witnesses went to watch the machine audit. A certain number of machines are tested. They put votes in. They then write down what the machine said the votes were. And in every case that they could witness, by the way, the auditors were trying desperately to cover up what was happening, which is, you know, illegal or should be, but where they were able to see it, every time the machines were not adding up and people were erasing numbers and fixing them so that it looked like the machines were working accurately. And, you know, there's organizations that have done great work on this, showing how these machines could be hacked in various areas, showing fractional voting, meaning you put in a little bit of code that makes it that every Bernie vote counts as 0.9 and every Hillary counts as 1.1 vote. And there's been some great work done on that. Black Box Voting has done great work on that, and Greg Palast has done great work on voter suppression. These things are not made up. They're very obviously happening. And the fact that our media flips out, our mainstream media flips out and acts like, oh, no, that could never be a thing, is, you know, it's a disgrace. It's disgusting.
Well, and part of the problem is, you know, when we look at the 2000 election, the 2004 election, after these elections took place, you know, Brad Friedman, Greg Palast did phenomenal work, black box voting, as you mentioned. And they talked about the fact, like, look, we knew these voting machines were flawed. We knew what they could do. We have this hacker who shows us how easily it can be done in 30 seconds. We need to do something. And the Democratic Party says, oh, my God, you're right. All right, let's do something. Let's do something. We win in 2008, and it dies. The whole issue, for the most part, dies, except among, you know, Palast and Friedman and black box voting, who are still saying, look, it's not solved just because you won an election. These things are still out there. And well, that's the Democratic problem is, oh, we won, the problem is solved.
Yeah, absolutely. And the only reason Obama won is because he was able to beat what was stolen.
Right.
He won by whatever, 5%, and he should have won by 10%, and no one cared afterwards just because he won. And so, you know, and there are currently there's a lawsuit that people can go watch the video at trustvote.org. There's currently a lawsuit by Cliff Arnbeck and Bob Fitrakis. Fitrakis has been around for, you know, almost two decades doing this kind of work. He may very well have saved Obama's reelection in 2012 because he spotlighted the fraud that was likely going to happen or happening in Ohio. Therefore, the fraud didn't happen because the spotlight was on them. The FBI was investigating. The Justice Department was investigating. So that very well might be why Obama won Ohio in 2012. But they have a lawsuit right now saying that the election is rigged against Bernie, the primary. And they believe, and I don't know, I have to take their word, they believe that very soon, meaning within days and a couple of weeks, the raw exit poll data showing fraud and the raw ballots should be presented to them as part of the case. Like, the court will mandate that they get to see this information and could very well open the whole can of worms and reveal that there has been a great fraud.
But what's interesting is last week, Thursday or Friday, Chris Matthews, MSNBC, says, look, before the voting even ends in California, we're going to go ahead and say that Hillary Clinton is the Democratic nominee.
Right.
He said that 5 days or 4 days before California even voted. And then, so the day before, the AP says, well, we're going to get a jump on Chris Matthews, and we're going to go ahead and just say Hillary Clinton's already won the nomination. And a lot of it, again, comes back to the fact that, look, the Democrats right now are using a little bit of this voter suppression, voting fraud, election fraud, whatever you want to call it, to their advantage. Just completely ignoring the fact that when November rolls around, yeah, Donald Trump, the racist who hates everything except old white men, he can win because you guys did nothing about this fraud. And in fact, you actually used it to help get your person elected. I mean, that is the great irony of today.
True, but what you just said about Donald Trump is despicable. He also likes young white women.
That's true. That's true. I forgot about those.
Matthews and other networks said that they would call it early, and they did. They, the AP announced the day before California voted that first they said Hillary Clinton has clinched the nomination, and then like five tweets later they said, oh, well, she's the presumptive nominee. And, you know, Glenn Greenwald did a great job writing about this. He's like, this is a not trustworthy mainstream media saying they've done some secret phone calls with secret superdelegates that they can't tell us who they are. We can't call them ourselves. And even if true, those superdelegates don't vote until July 25th. It's ridiculous. And then announce it on a day no one's voting. So no one's voting today. We've talked to our secret people. We secretly want to secretly say that Hillary is the winner. And, you know, it's disgusting, and it's journalistic malpractice, which is what Jan Kuger called it on CNN's Reliable Sources.
Well, you know, to me, it almost seems like we have media-sponsored voter suppression. If you go out the day before these five states vote and say it's over, why should I go vote? We know it's not over. I mean, but the media is trying to paint this picture that can't be painted.
Well, they're trying to make sure the establishment candidate gets in. And I think, you know, they saw the polls going into California and were worried and announced Hillary the winner because they didn't want to have to deal with what could happen if they don't.
So I guess the last question here is, how does this play out in November? Assuming we just continue to whistle past the graveyard, ignore this problem, what happens in November?
Well, in terms of this problem, I think this problem is going to go for a while, and it's not going to be fixed until we have a fully accountable system. We either have to go back to paper ballots with paper trails, that are better than the toilet paper that seems to be coming out of most of the system. We either got to go back to that, or we have to have, you know, some sort of open source code that everybody can check and view and reliable audits that people can go watch, and the Board of Elections doesn't go, oh, that's interesting that we stole the election. That's fascinating. Tell me more about it. So I think, yeah, this system needs to, people have to keep fighting for this no matter what the hell happens. In terms of what happens just in our political system, I think that, you know, and I've been saying this from the beginning, like, These things can't be about a man. It can't be about just Bernie. It's got to be about the ideas, and people have to keep fighting for those ideas. No matter what happens, it's the movement that the people have been activated by this election. I just hope they'll stay activated and keep caring and keep realizing that this corporate totalitarianism we seem to have is going to eat our environment and our future alive.
Lee Camp, redacted tonight, RT America. Thank you for talking with us today. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Is your medication helping or hurting you? Find out at drugsafetynews.com.